Good morning, dear students. You all are welcome to today's session. I am sure you are enjoying online classes and I hope you all are fine. Let's start today's session. You are going to learn in today's video about quadratic equations. So first, before starting this lesson, let me give you the gist of or flow of this lesson, what you are going to learn in this lesson, and later on we will see one by one all the concepts. So in this quadratic equation, first of all, you are going to get introduced with quadratic equations. Means, what are quadratic equations? After this, you have to, you are going to learn about standard form of quadratic equation. Then you are going to learn about various methods of finding solutions of quadratic equations. In this, you are going to learn the first method is factorization method. Next method is completing square method. After that, you are going to learn about nature of roots. Now here, what are roots? First of all, you should know. And then after nature of roots, you are going to learn about quadratic formula. By this formula, you are going to find roots of quadratic equations. So let's start with the first concept, what is quadratic equations, and get ready with your book and pen for writing down the notes. When we say about quadratic equations, you know that you have learned in lesson number 2, polynomials, what is quadratic polynomial. So let's revise or let's take one example of quadratic polynomial. Here, if I take x square minus 4x minus 5, here this is a quadratic polynomial. Why? Because its variable x has highest power 2. So it's a quadratic polynomial. Now when we want to find out zeros of this polynomial, we have to equate this polynomial to 0. And then, by factorizing this polynomial, what we get? We get the factors like these are the factors of this polynomial, and then we are equating these factors which are in linear form to 0. So, what are the zeros we get over here? So, we get here zeros as x is equal to 5 or x is equal to minus 1. So, you have learned about zeros of quadratic polynomial which we have turned into an equation. And this is nothing but a quadratic equation. And where these zeros of quadratic equations are known as roots of quadratic equation. They are also known as solution of quadratic equation. You have also seen the standard form of quadratic polynomial, which is ax square plus bx plus c. When you are equating to 0, we get this as an equation. And this equation is nothing but quadratic equation because the highest power of variable x is 2. And that's why here a should not be 0. So let's look at the definition of quadratic equation. So quadratic equation in variable x is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers and a should not be equal to 0. Now you know why a should not be equal to 0. If a will be 0, this whole term will be 0 and that cannot be a quadratic equation with highest power of variable x 2. It will be a linear equation like bx plus c is equal to 0. So I hope you have understood what is a quadratic equation. Now let's see examples. Now here I am taking the examples from textbook, NCERT exercise. So as we are solving this, as I am solving the examples on the board, you too have to write down the sums. Check whether the following are quadratic equations. The first example is in bracket 2x minus 1 into other bracket x minus 3 is equal to x plus 5. Bracket complete, in other bracket x minus 1. Now this is the example from exercise 4.1, question number 1, sub question 5. Here, now we will solve this LHS first. x into minus 3x, 3 is minus 6x. Now this is minus x and plus 3. Finally we get here 2x square minus 7x plus 3. RHS. Now we are solving the RHS. X plus 5, x plus minus 1 is equal to x square minus x plus 5x minus 5. That gives us x square plus 4x minus 5. Now this LHS is equal to RHS. So whatever the expressions we have got for LHS and RHS, we are equating them. So here we have 2x square minus 3x plus 3 is equal to x square plus 4x minus 5. Now, this 2x square minus x square will give us 1x square, or you can transpose this x square here. So finally we get x square minus 7x plus 4x. So that gives us minus 3x and plus 3 minus 5. So here we have minus 2, but that is it at RHS. So when you are transposing this here, we get here as plus 0. Now you can solve one more step here, that is 2x square minus, transposing here x square, minus 7x. Plus 3, transposing here we get plus 5 is equal to 0. So here we get x square minus x square x square. So here we get minus 11x and here we get plus 8. So what we get finally? This equation we get. Now it is just check this equation with the standard form of equation. It is whether it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 or not. And here we get yes. It is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Hence, the given equation is quadratic equation. So now let's solve the next example. Now the second example, x square plus 3x plus 1 is equal to x minus 2 whole bracket square. This example is again from exercise 4.1, question number 16. Now we are expanding this bracket. So since RHS, now we are not solving LHS because LHS is always in expanded form. This gives us this expansion. We are equating LHS is equal to RHS. That gives us now transpose each and every term of RHS to LHS by changing the sign and write those terms along with the like terms of LHS. So here it gets cancelled. Here we get 7x and here we get minus 3 is equal to 0. Now is it in the form of quadratic equation? Standard form of quadratic equation. So here it is not in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and hence the given equation is not in the form of not a quadratic equation. One more example we are seeing. This is the question number 8 of exercise 4.1. Sub question 8, question number 1. X cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 is equal to x minus 2 whole bracket cube. Now again we are expanding RHS. So since RHS is equal to x minus 2 whole bracket cube. If you remember the identity a minus b x minus y whole bracket cube, that gives us x cube minus 3 into x squared into 2 plus 3 into x into 2 square minus 2 cube, and then we get here as 3x cube minus 6x square plus 12x minus 8. Now write, equate this LHS equal to RHS. X cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 12x minus 8. Now we can transpose this all the terms of RHS to LHS. X cube minus 4x square plus 6x square. This minus while transposing becomes plus. Minus x. Now this 12x while transposing becomes minus 12x. Now plus 1 minus 8 will become plus 8 is equal to 0. So this gets cancelled. What is the operation or answer of this? That is 2x squared. This one minus 13x. This one plus 9 is equal to 0. Now compare this with the standard form of quadratic equations. Yes. So we can say it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. And we can say hence the given equation is in the form of is a quadratic equation. So with these examples, I hope you have understood about how to check the quadratic equation when the equations are given in any form. When we deal with real life situations, we come up with quadratic equations. In this example, we are going to see how to represent the given situation in the form of quadratic equation. Here, Rohan's mother is 26 older than him. The product of their ages in years, 3 years from now, will be 360. We would like to find Rohan's present age. Again, this example is from exercise 4.2, question number 2, sub question 3. Sorry, it's exercise 4.1. So let's start the solving. So here, solution. What they have given, Rohan's mother is 26 years older than Rohan. So let Rohan's age be x years. Here, Rohan's present age is very important to write, because they have asked us find present age. So let Rohan's present age be x years old. Therefore, Rohan's mother's present age will be x plus 26 years. Now in the next line, they have given the product of their ages is 3 years from now will be 360. So first we will find Rohan's age 3 years from now. It means after 3 years. So he will be 3 years older, x plus 3. Similarly, mother's age 3 years from now will be x plus 26 plus 3, so that we get as x plus 29 years. All these are in years. And they have given that product of their ages after 3 years will be 360. So what the equation we write here? According to question, equation will be x plus 3, Rohan's age, into mother's age, x plus 29, is equal to 360. Now, we are going to write the product of these two linear factors, and that gives us x squared plus 29x plus 3x plus 87 is equal to 360. Now, if you add this, what we get? X square plus 32x plus 87, transposing 360 over here, we get here. And then finally, the answer is x square plus 32x minus 273 is equal to 0. And now this is a equation in the quadratic form for given situation. So this is how we have represented the given situation in quadratic equation. Let's see one more example. In this example, the example is given: a train travels a distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, then it would have been taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We need to find the speed of train. So what they have asked us, speed of train, so they have asked us to find this. So we will let that speed of train be x. But before we are solving this, let's see the concept of distance, speed and time. So how we write that distance, speed and time? So speed is equal to distance upon time. Or you can express this as time is equal to distance upon speed. Now, in the first case, when the distance is 480 km and if we take speed of train is x, we get time 1. And then, in other case, when the speed is reduced, it takes 3 hours more to cover the same distance and that will be time 2. So, we are expressing this as time 1 and time 2. Two different times we get with two different speeds. Right? Now, let's start the example. So, let the speed of train be x. So, the first situation, with the first situation, what we get, time 1 is equal to 480 upon x. This is 1. Now, if the speed is reduced by 3 hours, speed is reduced by 8 km per hour, the time taken is 3 hours more. So, here the second time will be, if the reduced speed, time 2 will be 480 with the speed reduced. X minus 8, you need first speed is x minus 8. Then how much time it takes? It takes 3 hours more. It's not plus 3 over here. It is 3 hours more with time 1. So what equation we get here? We get this equation that T2 is equal to T1 plus 3. So we get from here T2 is equal to T1 plus 3. And that gives us, what is T2? T2 is 480 upon x minus 8 is equal to, what is T1? That is 480 upon x and plus 3 over here. So now whatever the equation we have got here, that is the equation 3, and we are solving this equation 3, which will give us the quadratic equation. So I am solving it here. What it is, 480 upon x minus 8, bring this, transpose this here, that gives us 480 upon x is equal to 3. Now find out the LCM of this, that gives us 480x minus 480 into x minus 8 upon x into x minus 8 is equal to 3. So after this I am solving it here. Please try to understand. So it gives us 480x minus 480x plus 3280 upon x square minus 8x is equal to 3. Now if you take this 3 at this side, it gives us 480 minus 480 cancelled. Here we get 3280 is equal to 3 into x square minus 8x. And then we get from here as 3280 is equal to 3x square minus 8x. Now if you transpose whatever is at RHS to LHS, we get here minus 3x square plus 8x plus 3280 is equal to 0. So you can remove this minus sign, so other sign will change, and then finally I get here as the equation as 3x square minus 8x minus 3280 is equal to 0. So from this you can directly see this. So I hope you have understood this concept, how to check the quadratic equations and how to represent the given situation in the form of quadratic equations. Now we are going to see the method of solving the quadratic equations. Now we have to find the solution of quadratic equation by factorization method. In the beginning of the video only I have told you factorization method is one of the methods to find out the solution of quadratic equation. Now quadratic equation solution we get by factorizing the quadratic equation, and the roots of quadratic equations are nothing but they are equal to the zeros of polynomial. So here we can say alpha a real number is a root of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. It means alpha satisfies the given equation. What means satisfies? It gives the value of whole equation at 0. And therefore we can say x minus alpha is solution of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Now let's find solutions of quadratic equations with various examples. Here we have to find the roots of this quadratic equation, root 2 x square plus 7 x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0 by factorization method. Here I have mentioned this sum from exercise 4.2. Now you know this and this, multiplication of this gives us root 2 into 5 root 2 is equal to 10. Factorize this 10 gives us, factors of 10 should give us the sum 7. So you know 5 2s are 10. So sum of this will give us 7. So here we write 2x square plus 2x plus 5x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. Now from this common factor is root 2x. Now here if you root 2 is taken here, we get here in this term x. But root 2 from this is taken over here, so we get here only root 2. Because 2 is nothing but root 2 into root 2. So from this root 2 is taken here, so what remained? Root 2 is remained in this term. Plus, what is common? 5. So 5, x plus root 2 is equal to 0. So x plus root 2 is a common bracket, take it one time, and in other bracket root 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now how to find the roots of equation? by equating these linear factors. Sorry, this is multiple. By equating linear factors to 0. So here we get x plus root 2 is equal to 0 or root 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. That gives us here x is equal to minus root 2 or x is equal to minus 5 upon root 2. So these are nothing but the roots of this equation, quadratic equation. Let's see the second example. 2x square minus x plus 1 upon 8 is equal to 0. Now here this term, constant term is 1 upon 8, a fraction. So we will convert this into a whole number by multiplying or finding the LCM of these two as well. So this gives us what? 16x square minus 8x plus 1 upon 8, which we are taking to other side. So that will become 0 over here when you are multiplying by 8 over here. So I hope you have understood this. Now let's find the factors by splitting method. So here 16 into 1 product is 16. The answer we should have minus 8 as sum. So that gives us 4 into 4 is 8. So minus 4 plus minus 4 gives us minus 8. So here 16x square minus 4x minus 4x plus 1 is equal to 0. From this 4x minus 1, minus 1 if you remove from these two, what we have 4x here. Minus 1 into 4x gives us minus 4x. But now minus minus gives us plus 1. So here we get 4x minus 1. In other bracket, 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. Equating these linear factors to 0, we get here 4x minus 1 is equal to 0 or 4x minus 1 is equal to 0. So here we have x is equal to, transposing this we get plus 1, dividing these two other side we get 1 upon 4. Or x is equal to again 1 upon 4. These are not but roots of quadratic equation, given quadratic equation. In this example, we are going to represent a given situation in quadratic form and then we are finding the roots of quadratic equation. So, solution. Find two consecutive positive integers, sum of whose squares is 365. I have written it is from exercise 4.2, fourth question. So let two consecutive positive integers be x and x plus 1. One after another means consecutive integers. Now sum of squares is 365. That means according to question, equation will be x square plus x plus 1 whole bracket square is equal to 365. Expand this, x square plus x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 365. It is 2x square plus 2x plus, transposing this it becomes minus 365. So finally we get here 364. 1 minus 365 gives us minus 364. Now if you see there 2, 2 and here it's a common even number. So we can remove this 2 by dividing both the sides by 2. So that gives us x squared plus x minus 182 is equal to 0. I hope you have understood this. Dividing this whole quadratic equation by 2, we get this equation. Now factors of minus 182. Minus 182. which should give us the sum as plus 1. And they are 13 and 14. Now, if you see, this is my sum as plus sign. So, greater integer we have plus sign and this minus sign. So, by splitting method, we have found what? Minus 13x plus 14x minus 182 is equal to 0. Now, you know, find out the common from these two terms. Sorry, it's minus. Plus 14 is common from this. So, this is how we get x minus 3, 13, and here x plus 14 is equal to 0. Now, equating these linear factors to 0, we get here x minus 13 is equal to 0 or x plus 14 is equal to 0. From this, we get x is equal to 13 or here we get x is equal to minus 14. Now, we have to see what they have asked and what they have given. They have given consecutive positive integers. So, can this minus 14 be a positive integer? No. And that's why a required answer or root of this equation, a required root is 13. And hence, the consecutive positive integers are 13 and 14. In this example, the situation given is the altitude of right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. Now, you know, a right triangle base is, suppose we have taken x and its altitude is 7 less, so it will be 7 minus x. Then hypotenuse they have given us 13 cm. So this is the situation. So here, how to get it by Pythagoras property? Sum of squares of base and the altitude is equal to square of hypotenuse. So we will start with, let the base be x. So its altitude is x minus 7. Now, according to question, equation we will get as x square plus x minus 7 whole bracket square is equal to 13 square using Pythagoras property. X square plus x square minus 14x plus 49 is equal to 169. So expanding this, we get this. This is 2x square minus 14x plus 49 minus 169 gives us 2x square minus 14x minus 120 is equal to 0. Again, if you see, the coefficients of these are even and constant term is even, so we can remove this. So that gives us x squared minus 7x minus 16 is equal to 0. Now splitting this middle term, what the factors we get? Minus 16. Factors of this are 12 5s are 16. The difference of that we get as minus 7. And here minus 7 should, minus 12 should have minus sign, or 12 should have minus sign and 5 should have plus sign. That gives the difference minus 7. So here x squared minus 12x plus 5x minus 16 is equal to 0. Then we get here x minus common factor from these two terms, x minus 12, x is common, plus 5 in bracket x minus 12 is equal to 0. So that gives us x minus 12 as one of the linear factor, other is x plus 5. Equating this, what we get? X minus 12 is equal to 0. So that gives us x is equal to 12. Right? Now x plus 5 is equal to 0. That gives us x is equal to minus 5. Now base cannot be minus. So which root we have to take here? We have to take 12. And hence we can say, so here we can say base is equal to x, that is 12 centimeter, and altitude is x minus 7, which is 12 minus 7 gives us 5 centimeter. So you can write here, hence the other two sides are are 12 centimeter and 5 centimeter. I hope you have understood this. This is how we have taken many examples from exercise. Remaining sums of exercise 4.1 and 4.2 you can solve. And if you have any difficulty, we will see it afterwards. So I'll stop here, and the next concept we will see in the next video. Till then, keep solving the sums. Bye.